Hello everybody, Star here, and today we're looking at some medic gameplay on Bad Water. I am playing defense in the first round. Second round is going to be offense. There are two gameplays here, pretty long. I've cut out a decent amount of parts because some gameplay for medic can be a little bit boring when you're just charging with Uber. In the beginning, right off the bat, giving an Uber to somebody I do not know. I do not know anybody I play with. Usually when I'm a medic, I don't know anybody in the server worth Ubering, which is the case here for the first two Ubers that I do, and that is the main reason why I usually do not play medic. I enjoy it when I have someone good working with me, but most of the time I do not. Here is a good example of when I do not have those people to work with. So just giving it to random people. I believe he killed one person. I don't quite remember. The next Uber I give is kind of my fault why it doesn't go well, but it still does not. Later in this video, I do find somebody who consistently does well, very good player. I continue to give him Ubers throughout the video, so it did turn out very well. And I thought it would make a good medic video because I'm actually working with someone who knows what they're doing. Did not know him prior to this, still don't really know him, didn't add him or anything. But it worked out really well. And I guess it's a good time to say that if you are a good person, yeah, you can go ahead and add me on Steam. I don't really care if you are or not, but I'm just saying that lately I have been finding more good people to Uber because people have been adding me because of this channel. You can find my Steam account name listed on my main page. If you can find that, I guess you have earned the privilege of adding me. It's not that hard to do, and you know what I mean. So, locked in this corner, I felt really unsafe here in the first place. This is why I backed myself into the corner. Well, I felt unsafe, so I backed myself into the safe corner with the sentry. Only way to get out was to use an Uber, and it didn't go very well. So, continuing my quest to finding a suitable partner to spend my life with as a medic. That is very dramatic. I'm gonna try and get some tips in here too. You're gonna notice throughout the video that I keep my back to walls at almost all times. Someone calls out here that there's a sniper behind the roof, so I run to behind this big ventilation shaft before, a little bit after stabbing that soldier at least once. Whenever someone's singled out, I always go for the Uber stab. Because, why not? I mean, there was no reason not to there unless you got a really, really lucky crit on me, which would have been unfortunate, and that's the usual luck that I have in these games, but it did not happen there. So now I'm hiding behind this vent because there was a sniper back there, keeping my back to the wall as well, so that spies have a much more difficult time getting to me. I shouldn't be crouching. I think I was there. Crouching is also a bad idea. Keeping your back to a wall and crouching is, like, completely redundant because spies can actually jump on your head and, you know, still get behind you that way. So I tell this guy, Trollface2Pro, that I am interested in him, and I want to Uber him. And it was very romantic, and he said, okay, give me a second, and we actually did communicate on this one, and I let him know that I was going to do it. So it goes pretty well. We pushed him back pretty far. I decided that he was worth doing it to, by the way, because he does have an unusual hack. You can't see the particle effect on it right now for some reason. It's a little bit messed up, but you should be able to see that later in the video. And he did also have, I forget the name of his minigun, but it is a rare one that's hard to get and really has no purpose to it other than being rare, which you got from Med the Inventory, the poker game, which was released a while ago. So I knew he must have at least played this game for a little while to have an unusual hat and such, so he must know what he was doing. Seemed like a good idea, and it really worked out, so I continued communicating with him the rest of the game. Also, by the way, another reason why I wanted to was because he actually called out spies earlier in the game, so I knew he was communicating, which is very important, as I was saying. We get completely jumped here, so I jump off the roof. As soon as you sense any danger, even if you're dedicated healing someone, it is more important that you get out of there with your Uber charge than to stand around and risk losing it. So, skipped a little bit here. I just stayed around this area and healed people until I had my charge ready. Unfortunately for this one, I did not let him know that I was going to do it to him. He was a little bit unprepared. We don't get anyone because they all sort of scramble and run away into that corner. I think if we would have charged forward and I'd used it later, that he would have caught quite a few people off guard, but unfortunately I did not. Really should have talked to him on that one. So after he dies, we hook up again. Oh, so sexy. And I've already got about half my charge ready. We are almost ready to go on another spree, which continue to go on throughout the video. Still keeping my back to wall as much as I possibly can, sort of juking my back against the wall, which is very important. Throughout this video, I constantly look behind myself, all of that stuff, because he's already looking in front of us in most of the situations. So as a medic, it is a good idea to look behind and not actually look at the person that you're healing if you know what they're doing. Generally, especially with heavies, you can tell where they are because their miniguns are so loud. So even if you turn around, you can get a good idea of what exactly they're doing. So once again, he died. Came look for him. How stupid am I? I keep doing that today. I've actually done a couple takes on this because Audacity continues to crash. But anyway, moving up here with an Uber was a good choice by him to go this way. If you're heavy and you want some tips there, always going around, keep on hitting people from the side like this is a great, great choice. So you get a shit ton of people, push them back, even get a sentry gun as it was being built. Unfortunately, Super Spy stabs me in the back as I just gave you that tip earlier to always look behind yourself. So I should have been doing that. I really wasn't as worried about it because I had the Uber and I wasn't really thinking that someone would have gotten behind us there. But that just goes to show you that no matter what you think, people always end up behind you. That just seems to be how it works. So there are two types of medics in my opinion. One is a field medic. Well, actually three types if you want to include battle medic, but they aren't real medics. They're kind of just annoying to have on your team sometimes. So two types of medics. One is field medic, where you go out and you heal the people who need it on the battlefield, and trying to charge up an Uber-ish medic. I don't really have a word for it here, but pretty much what I'm doing is that one. Is a lot of the times in this video, I'm just charging the Uber on people who are in really safe areas. As you can see, there are some sentries up there, so I knew that there was no way a spy or anything like that was going to get to me, and as soon as it's about ready, then we push in for, you know, a big collective push rather than just a slow heal and risk death. So throughout this video, that is what I'm doing. Of course, being a field medic is very, very useful, but just wasn't what I was doing here. He tells me to use it, he calls out, and we get a shit ton of people in this room. Very happy with how this one went. We get a sentry teleporter. At least four people, I think. One, two, probably like six, maybe. I don't know. I can't count that right now. It's kind of small on my screen. And who really cares about the specifics anyway? So I ran away, because I thought he died, but I actually looked up the kill feed. He killed three more people after I left. He really went crazy on these guys, which is why, another reason why I continued to Uber him throughout the video, is because after you do that well with someone on an Uber, it's not worth risking it on somebody else. There are so many times, if you played medic a lot, you'll run into someone where you'll Uber them and they'll like taunt at you and be like, hey, I'm wasting it, aren't I cool? Or they'll like run backwards to try and get a heal while they're invulnerable, and you just, it's so disappointing when that happens. Finally, to have somebody reliable to give it to is a very, very good thing in public servers, which I have not had the privilege of too often. Once again, going back to the side door, it's an excellent route. Not a lot of people use it. Usually only like snipers and spies go up that way because it gives them a very good vantage point, if you know what I mean. And if you know what I mean, that, I don't know, that sounded weird. We win this round pretty easily after all that shit goes down, and it was a good one. So, switching it up, we go on to offense, and one important tip, which he says as well as I say right afterwards because I did not notice what he said, was that I was going to wait a little bit to give him the Uber because you do not want to run right out the door as soon as the round starts with an Uber in most cases, because the other team will also have it. You want them to use theirs first so that when you use yours, they don't get in the way of you. You know what I mean? You don't want the clash of invulnerable people, and you pretty much completely wasted against theirs. So I'm trying to hold off on this as long as possible. He says, let's make a run for the tunnel, which I completely agree with. We're kind of footing around, and unfortunately, I did not even see that the pyro had stickies out there. So that Uber already went really badly. Fortunately, my team is still pushing very well throughout the rest of this video. By the way, right here, I turn around, still checking my back, always checking my back, and I really should have called it out, but there is a pyro behind us, and I am the only person who doesn't get lit on fire by him, because I checked my back. And like I said, I would have called it out, but by the time I saw him and would have had time to say it, they would have been like, no shit, there's a pyro behind us, I'm on fire. And a lot of the times that's why I don't call things out. There was a spy earlier also that was like right next to the person I was healing. If they didn't see them when they saw them, me calling it out would have had no purpose. But definitely call out spies and shit like that when you do see them and nobody else does, and there is time for you to say it, and then time for them to react. Always very helpful. A little bit disappointed here. There's medics all healing up on my dude. So I figure, meh, it's not worth it. No reason for two medics to be on one guy, wasting my time there. I'll let him have him. I'm a little bit jealous. So I run away, go over here, heal this dude. He probably would have died without me, so that's good. I saved someone's life in the process of giving up my true love, and we continue to push the cart. As a medic, as I've been saying this whole time, it is important to stay on the front lines as well as keep yourself safe. You definitely need to get used to where to stand as a medic. Like here, I'm in this tunnel. You want to stand behind cover at all times and still try and keep a good line of sight on the people that you're covering, as well as, when possible, keeping your back to the wall and checking your back. Very important to always stay behind cover whenever possible. If someone is turning a corner and you're not sure what's around that corner yet, let them go first. It's always better to preserve a medic than it is to give him that 10 extra heal that he would have if you would have went around that corner just as fast as him. Keep your maximum distance from people whenever possible. Whenever a situation like this corner, there's no way I'm looking around this corner. I know this is a huge choke point. I'm keeping my back to the wall, letting them all go first. And when I see that they're doing a steady, really good push, I let them go. They used an Uber, so I did not use mine, which was good because theirs didn't go very well anyway. We get down here into this last main area where I am able to use mine. He takes out quite a few people, really shuts down the area. We really, really steamrolled them on this match. It pretty much goes to a win right after this. Right after I die, I respawn and we've won the game. Please let me know if you've liked this video in the comments, and press the like button, because it lets me know that you've liked it. Oh no, there's one more. There's one more Uber. Holy crap. Oh my god. It's like an extra. It's like a bonus. Oh my god. Oh no, I thought it was over. But anyway, as I was saying, like the video if you did. Leave comments if you want to. Subscribe for more of these videos. I really appreciate it. Like video lets me know that people are watching these, and I will continue to make more of them. So if you don't want me to make more videos, dislike and tell me that I'm a big fat loser and I should get outside. So yeah, this is pretty much the same scenario where we've pushed up really far. I'm running around checking all these different areas. I was actually a little bit worried about spies here. As I mentioned, I did check my back 100 more times here. And when I finally do get the Uber, I notice him in his swirly little funky peace hat, because that heavy definitely wants to bring peace to his enemies. And we jump down here, and oh, last big tip here is when someone has a sentry and you have a heavy especially, jump in front of the sentry, because sentries push you back when you are Ubered. They'll slow down the heavy and you won't be able to walk towards them. So if you run in front of the sentry, that knockback effect will be applied to you and not the heavy, so he'll be able to push up closer to the sentry, which he even thanked me for. It's so sweet. Thank you guys for watching. I already did my outro I love you guys voice talk, so see you later.